I found his story to be so inspiring that I knew I had to find a way to bring it to the big screen.
Given the nature of the R-rated movie, lots of families didn't feel comfortable with their children seeing it.
Now, I know I'm a little late here on getting to this video, but there's a reason for it, and I'll show you towards the end of this video, so make sure you stay. But Mark Wahlberg had this passion. He was so inspired by the story of Father Stu that he had to make the movie. He starred in it. He funded it. So what I want to do is watch the trailer, right? I have seen the movie. We're going to watch the trailer, and then we're going to watch the update, which is the surprise, the twist here that is you're going to love. So let's watch the trailer first. We'll react to this, and we'll get on to the second part. Let's check it out.
Hey everyone, I'm Mark Wahlberg. I am so excited to share with you the trailer for my new movie, Father Stu. I found his story to be so inspiring that I knew I had to find a way to bring it to the big screen. Here's the trailer to Father Stu. I figured it out.
Yeah, seventh time's a charm.
I'm being an actor.
Oh God. You don't belong with those LA folks. They're a bunch of fascist hippies.
What brings you here?
And I figured no better place to be discovered than the supermarket.
Hey, did I see you on a television series?
You do movies? You don't work in the entertainment industry at all?
No, man.
Did Bill know you're fussing with his truck?
I'm the son. I'm just borrowing it.
I reckon it's a few months worth of cleanups on aisle four to pay off a DUI impound.
What can I get for you, miss? I got beef.
I can see that.
Hey! Hey!
Let's not waste either of our time. I'm a Catholic.
Well, ain't that what confession's for?
You can't date someone who isn't baptized.
Such a good movie.
I thought you was gonna say Hispanic. Where's the water? I'll do it now.
I know I'm not what you used to. And not what you deserve either.
Life's gonna give you a gut full of reasons to be angry. You only need one to be grateful. Oh!
I think God saw something in you worth saving. But it's up to you to decide what you've got to offer.
This is the place you told me you believed in me. I thought it makes sense being back here to do this.
Your son is about to make a huge mistake.
Well, I'm gonna be a priest.
For Halloween.
For Halloween.
I'll pray for you, Bill.
Don't you dare. You're violating my rights.
There's a man going around taking names.
We've all been wrong, and we've all done some wrong.
But he came to forgive us.
Everybody won't be treated all the same.
There's no easy way to deliver this news. You have a progressive muscle disorder. Muscles weaken until they cease to function.
Is there anything it doesn't mess with?
Yeah, erectile function.
I'm trying to be a priest, pal.
The wise men will bow down before the throne.
Oh, no.
No.
Why?
He's late. And at his feet, they'll cast their golden crown.
Man don't lose when he gets knocked down, but when he won't get up.
Ah, baby.
There is concern amongst the diocese that your infirmity will render you unable to be a priest.
Listen to the words long written down.
What you guys get, one phone call a week in here? Who you gonna call, huh? When no one else gives a shit what you got to say, God does.
When the man comes around.
He ain't giving up on you. Don't you dare go giving up on yourself.
Hear the trumpets, hear the pipers. 100 million angels singing.
Where are you going?
Well, I gotta get your ass to church on time.
Who are you here to visit, sir?
Father Stu.
You and everybody else.
When the man comes around.
I wish you can pray for an easy life. But the strength to endure a difficult one. Well, you can't say I never gave you nothing.
Yeah, I skipped over thanking you. Went straight to the source.
Exclusively in movie theaters.
Okay, so again, this movie came out last year. It's been a little under a year since it came out in 2023 of April. And Mark Wahlberg, again, he produced it. He was inspired by this true story. He was the actor in it, Father Stu. He was a boxer that pretty much got injured so many times that he couldn't do it anymore. And so he's on this search. He meets this girl. She's Catholic, and he converts because he loves her. And he's trying to. They come from two different worlds. It's pretty beautiful the way that it works out. And so he's in this. He decides that he's going to be a priest. And he feels called to do it. And everybody's like, you're crazy, right? And all of these, you saw the trailer. So inspiring. And then he finds out he has this muscular disease, which over time his muscles just begin to disintegrate. They begin to just weaken until he can't move anymore, until finally like his heart gives out. And so he's not going to give up. He's not going to let it get him down. And as you saw in the trailer, this is the real life story of him. Now, one of the reasons why I wanted to do this video was not only to bring light, in case you haven't seen this movie, it was really good, but the version that we just watched, the trailer that we just watched, is rated R. So you really can't watch it with your kids, because there's some cussing, a lot of cussing in it, you know, smoking and violence and things like that. But the message is so great about not giving up and about overcoming in the face of fear and pushing through and only, you know, following God no matter what it takes, and all of these amazing message of his life that the producer but Sony, I believe, was the company, we'll find out here in a second, that produced it. They decided they were going to re-release this movie in theaters, but take out all the cuss words because there were so many kids who would benefit from watching this. So I want you to hear this interview, and then we'll comment on it. It's beautiful.
Earlier this year, Mark Wahlberg's passion project, Father Stu, a redemptive tale of a roustabout who finds God and ends up saving his family in the process. It made a huge splash at the box office. Well, now in an unorthodox move, Sony is bringing the movie back to theaters at the top of December in a new form. They call it Father Stu Reborn. Joining me to discuss is the film star and producer, Mark Wahlberg. Mark, thanks for being with us, for taking a little time from your Thanksgiving Eve. Now, this is an odd move, Mark, to release a movie in the same year it was originally released. Why did you and the studio decide to do it this way?
Listen to his response. It's super cool.
Well, given the nature of the R-rated movie, lots of families didn't feel comfortable with their children seeing it, but they really wanted them to get the message. So because the Archbishop, Archbishop Thomas of Nevada, who had actually ordained Father Stu in Helena, Montana, came to me and said, Mark, I really understand why the language is there, but it would be a sin and a shame for young people not to see this movie and to really understand the importance of this story. Mm.
No, I agree with that, because I didn't think of it that way. It'd be a sin and a shame, but it was such a good movie. And I was thinking to myself, man, I need to share this movie with my church and recommend it. Then I was thinking, I don't know if I can, because it's kind of, it's a little gritty, right? It's a little rated R-y, right? So, but listen to this. This is so cool.
So we wanted to make sure that we could share that with children of all ages. And so we recut the film. We took out all 200 and some odd swears.
Aspen. Stop scratching over there. Okay.
And the film is still as powerful and as impactful. But to see Stu's journey and the struggle that he went through to find his calling, we felt was really important for people of all ages to see.
Well that's what I was going to ask you. Roslyn Ross, who was your director here, she told me she cut out about 200 expletives. It took her a couple of weeks.
See, when we say there was cuss words, about 200, right?
Is it now like a 20-minute movie? Is this double time, Stu, Mark? What do you lose in the process or gain?
You really didn't lose anything. I think especially for young people, they will definitely be impacted by, especially by Stu's conviction and seeing the story and the struggle and how he handled adversity and struggling and suffering the way that he did and really embraced it and found his calling to serve God. But I remember seeing Hard Times in the theater with my dad when I was 7 or 8 years old. Had a profound impact on me, and it didn't have any bad language. It did have bare knuckle boxing. Mm-hmm. But I think then it will allow children to then go and see the movie in the way that it was originally intended when they get a little bit older and it's more age appropriate for them.
Hmm. Why do you think it's important for kids and families, particularly boys, to see this movie now, Mark? I know that was a goal for you, that young boys should see this with their dads.
Yeah, I really wanted young people as a whole to see it, but especially young boys, because I think you really kind of hopefully can avoid making a lot of the mistakes that Stu made and going through a lot of the struggles that he did. I think, you know, it's a brutally honest depiction of somebody who's struggling, trying to find their own way, trying to find their calling, and kind of going through the hardships, especially living life and expressing anger in a way that is not really productive. I think Stu, if he had a chance, like all of us, to go back and do a differently, we would, but we want to prevent kids from making a lot of the same mistakes that we made, certainly mistakes that I made. So anything that we can do to kind of show them an easier path to serving God and just being positive, productive members of society and the community, and especially in the church, and gravitating towards their faith, whether that's Catholicism or Judaism or Islam or Buddhism or any other form of faith.
Well, so this is super cool. Again, obviously, we don't endorse everything, and I don't endorse a rated R version just because it's rated R, and I would want my church people to see it. And I want you to see it too. And if you're okay with that, watch the rated R version. But if you want your kids, especially guys, especially young men, right, who need a father figure, who need to learn how to make better decisions, and they're just listening to people like Andrew Tate and other people that are out there trying to influence how men should act and treat women, this is one of those movies where they can learn some things about life, where they could learn that hard things do happen. They could learn that families do break apart. They could learn that that God is real and he does have a purpose for our lives. And they could be inspired by that despite like the setbacks. And one of the things that I love is that when he felt called, he went with it. It's like God told him he was supposed to be a priest, right? And then he had this disease and he didn't let the disease stop him. Right. And so many times in our world, and you know, we run into obstacles, we run into things that we feel like, hey, it's over for me. If this happened, the universe must have said something and now it's not supposed to happen. No. You will face hard times in this life. Jesus said it. Right. And we're living a broken world. And so even if you're called, if you're listening to this and you're called to do something and it's been hard for you, or you've been going through some things, or you've been facing some trials and tribulations or whatever it might be, obstacles, setbacks, but you know, you need to do it. And I was talking to one of my instructors today at the gym, and I was telling her, I know I'm busy, but I know I need to do this channel because there's so many people that need to hear the gospel. There's so many things going on in our world that are incorrect about God, that are that need to be course corrected. So many people who have influence over so many other people, and they say something wrong about God, and I feel like, man, I need to make a video to correct that so that people don't view God that way. They view him the proper way, and not that I have all the answers. But some people say some really ignorant things about God. And then there are other people like Mark Wahlberg, who God is using in Hollywood, right? And Hollywood's becoming more accepting of Christian faith-based movies, if you will, all the way to allowing him to remix this, remaster it with no curse words, designed to reach younger kids, re-released in the movie theaters, right? So God's doing something. There's the Asbury revival. There's revivals coming out, popping up all over the world now. And we need to be open to that. We need to be open to a revival. We need to be open to getting back to doing what God has called us to do. You need to be open to that. So maybe you're listening to this. If God's calling you to do something and it implies doing hard things, do it. Do it in Jesus' name. Do it, right? Come on, right? So I just want to leave you with that this is a great movie. Go out and watch the clean version with your kids. Go out and watch the other version with your wife. I don't know. Who knows? Anyway, I'll see you on the next one.